هبدأ بالآية القرآنية. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه، ومن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر هأفعله، ومن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر، ده التبعيد أو البعض من الكل. يمكن شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن دوت صيام للمسلمين عامة، لكن اختص منهم المرضى إن هم سمح لهم بالإفطار for fasting. As we know that Ramadan is one of the five pillars of Islam, which are shahada, salah, saum, zakah, and hijj. I'll speak about physiopathological aspect of Ramadan and diabetes. Diabetes and Ramadan practical guidelines 2021, published about 2 months earlier than now, contain about 15 chapters, all related about diabetes. Within the Muslim community, there is an intense desire to participate in fasting, even among those who are eligible for exemption. The timing of Ramadan is based on the lunar calendar, which is, as we know, about 355 days. This makes variations that Ramadan run around all year's months. So, in some parts of the world, daylight can last up to 20 hours in peak of summer. And also climate may be play a role during Ramadan if come in hot weather. Ramadan fasting affects several fundamental aspects of human physiology, like glucose homeostasis, lipid change, energy balance, fluid balance, and also sleeping better and circadian rhythm during. As we knew also, when compare sleep and the meal pattern during Ramadan and the non-Ramadan period, we will find that continuous sleeping at night make that no interruption of sleep, but interruption of sleep occurs during Ramadan because of woke up to take suhoor. This makes disturbance in decreased rapid eye movement, sleep duration, which is very important during sleep. Also, sleep deprivation has been associated with decreased glucose tolerance. This study showed total sleep time before Ramadan in Sha'ban and during Ramadan months. And also, there is found that there is change in indication of the body clock mechanism. The body clock mechanism is deviated or is changed in this time, and affect many hormonal rhythms, as we will see in the next slides. Also, we take in the physiology. Physiology of feeding in healthy individual as the response of eating or after meal in response to high glycemic load and secretion of insulin, which stimulate glycogen storage in the liver and the muscle, and also inhibit gluconeogenesis and ketogenesis to preserve glucose level normal during the after eating. This process actually is reverse manner while fasting. While fasting, there is decrease in insulin level and the inhibit glycogen stored depletion of glycogen storage, and also leading to stimulation of gluconeogenesis. This chart illustrates the five metabolic stages between the post-absorptive state and prolonged starvation. What happened post-eating? As we see here, first stage, the depend the body on exogenous glucose. Then when it blood glycogen will be used for supply body with glucose, and then gluconeogenesis will start later. This may give us some idea about if we make omission of suhoor leads to the depletion of glycogen stores and results in ketotic state much earlier in the fasting state. And when this ketotic state starts, it may good for weight loss and help some way. This chart illustrated by Professor Ines Chaldut about the but this in the healthy person. This is continuous glucose monitoring in healthy person show us there is no difference between before Ramadan and after Ramadan. This is the red line. Red line illustrated during Ramadan, where there is some increase in the glucose level after iftar, related, of course, to carbohydrate-rich foods typically taken at this time. This is in diabetic patient. Diabetic patients liable for hypoglycemia before time of iftar, and then rapid rise of glucose in the blood, hyperglycemia after iftar. Also, there's changes in hunger satiety cycle during Ramadan, and there is difference between male and female late in Ramadan, where there in females to show some adaptation seems to occur around late days in Ramadan, where the hunger rate during fasting hours appears to reduce in intensity. The effect of fasting on hormones, especially GIT hormones. We will speak about adiponectin. Firstly, adiponectin is good hormone. Adiponectin regulate glucose level as well as fatty acid breakdown, inhibit gluconeogenesis, increase the insulin sensitivity. What about in Ramadan? In Ramadan, there is a reverse of the level of adiponectin, in which there is reduction in the morning adiponectin level. Occur. What about leptin? Leptin is a satiety hormone, has a negative effect on feeding through its effect on the hypothalamus in healthy individuals. Leptin also, leptin level rise in response to food. Its secretion follow in a circadian rhythm, with peak of leptin occurs from 10 p.m. till 3 a.m. In Ramadan or during fasting, leptin become يعني level large increase in the morning in Ramadan or in fasting. Another hormone is known as ghrelin. Ghrelin is also an appetite stimulating peptide hormone. Levels are high pre-prandial and drop after eating, of course. Study found that there is may no significant difference in ghrelin, but other studies found that in obese patients there is some decrease in the level of this hormone ghrelin at the end of Ramadan. This chart also illustrates the level of leptin, adiponectin, high sensitivity reactive protein, huma insulin R, day and night, and in Sha'ban, yani before Ramadan and during Ramadan. Another hormones affected during fasting is growth hormone. Growth hormone also reduced as a response to reduce the insulin level, which enhance glycogenolysis and prevent hypoglycemia. Moreover, this process followed by elevation of what is known as counter-regulatory hormones, like glucagon hormone, increased growth hormone, and catecholamines. All are involved in stimulation of gluconeogenesis and ketogenesis. And also growth hormone is known to increase availability and utility of fats for fuel, which is good and well. It also helps to preserve muscle mass and bone density. Another hormone actually is affected during fasting is testosterone. Modest reduction in testosterone in men have also been reported. وده خلينا نقول الحديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج فإنه أغض للبصر وأحسن للفرج ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم فإنه له وجاء. فده effect of fasting on testosterone. What about effect of fasting on cortisol? Cortisol is glucocorticoid hormone, as we know, and under hypothalamic pituitary control axis, secretion of adrenal secreted from adrenal cortex, and the cortisol secretion is characterized by circadian rhythm, has a circadian rhythm, increase in the morning and decrease in the evening. This due to disturbance of what is known as sleep during Ramadan. This circadian rhythm also disturbed. Ramadan fasting and gene expression. Although genes are inherently fixed and can't be changed throughout the human life, as we know, it's well established that dietary and lifestyle behavior affect human genes expression in a way that may modulate the risk of developing chronic disease such as diabetes. We need more and more study about gene and diabetes and many other chronic illness. Observation of fast during Ramadan on some genes like clock circadian rhythm controlling gene, which is related to sleep. And if our sleep is good and well, this gene expression is good. How in the morning become high, in the evening become low. During Ramadan, there is a reverse of this gene. And this reverse may affect all glucose homeostasis, leading to increased insulin resistance. The antioxidant gene also, another gene, is affected by upregulation, which is good. And another gene known as metabolism, controlling gene, affected by downregulation during fasting and give significant reduction. This results in the basis that Ramadan fasting may ameliorate gene expression of anti-inflammatory and antioxidant regulatory genes. Ramadan fasting may entail protective effect against oxidative stress, which is good and well, and also may have a good effect in non-diabetic obese individual. Ramadan fasting and gut microbiota. What about? We know about gut microbiota have emerged recently as an integral player in the progression of chronic disease of obesity and diabetes, alongside a range of other environmental and genetic factors. The most changes in gut microbiota has been found to affect body fat composition by changing the white adipose tissue into more affection on the mitochondria and change it into brown tissue. And it is very good effect, in my opinion. This in turn helps to increase energy expenditure and reduce the chance of developing obesity. Okay. About lipid, also fasting affect lipid profile either in the healthy patients or diabetic patients in good manner. The physiology of fasting in diabetic patients and affection of diabetic patients, 2 minutes. Pathophysiology of diabetes is insufficient insulin level. The causes as a pathophysiology of diabetes, insufficiency insulin level in type 1 or insulin resistance in type 2. Type of medication used by the patients is also affected by and has a reflect on the diabetic patients. In diabetic patients, glycogenolysis accelerates due to insulin absence or resistance, and also gluconeogenesis and ketogenesis are enhanced as well. Actually, an awareness of hypoglycemic attack may occur during diabetic due to autonomic neuropathy, and also likely to lose the defense mechanism to decrease the catecholamine level as well as glucagon level. Considering this physiological change, it seems that risk of hyperglycemia or hypoglycemia in the fasting state is higher in diabetic patients if they experience no change in their drug and dietary control, which must be updated before Ramadan. This may be the last slide, and I wanted to illustrate in it the level of blood glucose level at which hypoglycemia occur, and because of hypoglycemia or hypoxia is very dangerous to diabetic patient, either type 1 or type 2, we must know this level, please. Level below 90, inhibition of insulin secretion. Below 75, there is stimulation of glucagon, epinephrine, growth hormone secretion. Below 60, there is cortisol secretion stimulation, and at this level, this cognitive function is impaired. Then below 45, there is lethargy, and they make coma, and even death. Lastly, on the take-home message, as firstly, I start with آية من القرآن هنهي ببرضو نصيحة من سيدنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله تعالى يحب أن تؤتى رخصه كما يحب أن تؤتى عزائمه. Thank you.